My goodness, this also, when I first came here 20 years ago in Romeda Sarah's benefit, more than 20 years, I came in 1980. They told me this is Panihati Dham. Prabhupada gave the name Panihati Dham. So that's far out. So do you have a Chiradai festival here? And they said, Chiradai festival, what's that? You know? Heard about reading the scripture, so then they didn't know, exactly how to do it or anything. So since we've been doing it already in Mayapur for the Panihati, the real Panihati, so we had some experience of making Malsha Bogas. So then we started to put together a little festival here, and I said, well, we're here together, we should remember Prabhupada's pastimes here, because he visited this place, and he had for a number of days, his pictures are there in the back. You can see he had pastimes here, where he was, when the first time, when we had, I mean, nowadays it's hard to get all the old veterans to come back and share their, somewhere if someone goes through all my old tape ministry, then you can get those, because we recorded in those days. The different pastimes, to try to get them all together, put all the pastimes together over the years. And probably we have one today on Sunday when I'm cooking the chiradai. We used to have a loudspeaker that worked in the kitchen, now it's not so much working. But we would hear also in there the pastimes. And we do Leela Smaran on Prabhupada's pastimes here, especially here, but other people didn't have to share. I remember they would tell how people were chanting kirtan when Prabhupada was here. And you see this one picture somewhere, I don't know if it's here, but there's one picture where you see one person. You see literally his belly button above somebody else's head. I mean, I know it's like, it's pretty hard to jump that high. You gotta be an Olympic jumper or something, jump that high up. But that was the kind of people were like floating. It was like so much energy was there. It was like this picture we see, someone like that. It's like that. People said they were just like exploding and jumping high in the air. And then Prabhupada was chanting that song, Parama Karuna Pahudui Jana Nitai Gola Chandra, crying. Taught all the devotees how to chant it. So it was so many things were happening, and then people were. The normal kind of pastime for somebody goes, so why does that always smell fresh paint? You know, it was the hour before you arrive, he's finished painting his room or something. But I can't remember all the different pastimes, but different devotees, their perception, the realization. And Prabhupada said, this is the best temple. Of course, what happened that time, Radha Damodar Party was here. There was a lot of everybody from the whole East Coast that came here. And then Prabhupada, just after coming from, I think it was Caracas and Mexico City, came here.
Miami,
and then here. But it was after the Latin America, Miami, and here. So that time, they all came here and converged, and they had like a weekend festivities with Prabhupada. He started the Bhakti Vedanta Institute. You see the picture there of young Sri Garmander. He look, he's very young. When he was still just in college. So a lot of different things were happening here. Of course, at that time I was in India, but I was happy to hear the different devotees sharing. So how to create a festivity here, and how to create some kind of a culture here. That since Prabhupada gave the name Panihati, then we'll definitely need to have a chiradai. Flat rice and yogurt. And because here it's America, everything's more opulent. And here you get fruits from all over the world. And like in India, you get mangoes and lychees and a few fruits. Maybe jackfruit and all that. Bananas, mainly. But even that's just according to what's in season. But here you get the mangoes from Mexico, you get the peaches from the local, this is peach land. This is, and then and get, you know, dry fruits from all kinds of dry fruits, and get cherries, and all kinds of different fruits come into America from locally grown as well as imported. So we started making different flavors with different kinds of fruits. Like we would do in India, we'd make malsha bowl with yogurt, with condensed milk. But there wasn't so many varieties of fruits, so here you get big variety. A few years ago, we started a salad, salty chirudai, which is quite popular. And my mother came in and she said, why are you giving all this chirudai away for you? You should auction it. So we started auctioning, and one year, Ambarish Prabhu was here, and he offered, the bid went 400, 500, 600, went up, went over $1,000 for one pot of chirudai. Yes. Now it's regularly that it goes over 1,000, since he broke the barrier, the 1,000 barrier. Now, if someone pledges in advance, but if they, whatever is not pledged, there's a few pots that we auction off. It's quite common that somewhere during the auction, two people want the same pot so bad that the auction goes up to over 1,200. So that helps to finance the festival. But like that, this Panihati Prabhupada said is one of the eternal dhams. The Lord Chaitanya is eternally residing in Panihati. So just like you have Vrindavan and you have Mayapur, and Jagannath Puri, Dwarka, but then also Panihati is actually eternal dham. So I don't know how, I hope that in the generations and the yugas that come, the devotees will somehow keep up a Panihati spirit. Prabhupada, in his original charter for ISKCON, he said that we should one of our purposes in ISKCON is to make places of the transcendental pastimes of the Lord. And I don't remember that again. I'm paraphrasing, I can't remember the exact wording, but something dedicated to the transcendental pastimes of the Lord. So to hear what Prabhupada gives, a name to the place, it gives us an opportunity to dedicate some pastimes. And Panihati was, of course, famous for a number of things. The Chirudai festivals the focal point. But also it was the house of Raghava Pandit and Damayanti, who are super cooks. So it's important, I think, here that we have good feasts. Keep up the Panihati tradition. I don't know anybody who minds that, but it requires some cooking dedication. But that's one of the things about Panihati. Lord Nityananda would go there and he would have these feasts. Not only the Panihati, not only the Chirudai feast, but many times he would go. Other thing that happened was that was this place where Nityananda first started Namaha preaching.
Yay.
Later he made his headquarters in Navadvip at Sura Vikuncha, but when he came back from Jagannath Puri, he started his Bengal preaching initiative at Panihati. So it would be, we're always hoping that we could see the congregation expand more and more here. It's always been active, but America is a little bit slow congregationally compared to some of the other places. I don't know what's the secret to do. That, what's the... the secret to get it going. But it's going, I mean, it's going, it's not that it's not going, it's going different places and it's moving on. But, like I was just in Moscow, and they're trying to build up their congregation to having over 108 groups. And last time I was there, and a few months ago, they had 20 groups, and now they're up to 30. But they feel it. Moscow feels it's a bit slow for them, but they're so good trying. But in America, they don't have cities that have 20, 30 groups and not focused like that very much. You have some cities with one group, like that there was no temple in Israel, like the Namahata, etc. And you have big congregations that come to the temples, but Bhakti Vaishnava even comes to groups, or even Namahats. It's something that could be developed. I know that Kalada Srinivas was able to set up a Bhakti Vaishnava group in the Gulfport area of all middle class American people. So they still meet and they're still Krishna conscious. So it just shows that it can be done, just gotta penetrate the initial ice.